There are 750 cows in this barn alone, and these are just the replacements, young animals that will enter the milking herd once the older cows drop out. Raising these cows is Danny's job. One of the sons Leo hooked all those years ago, still doing chores at 51.
By the time I was 11 years old, I was doing my part in either the hennery or the dairy barn. So we all had our chores to do. And then when we're in our early teens, then we do the milking in the morning before school, and after school we get home in the evening.
Not much of a life for a teenager.
No, it wasn't, but I must say that I'm still at it.
Kids that works when they're young, they're gonna work. They're gonna work right through. It gives them a good start. And they worked hard, but I mean, I made sure they got to their sports and whatever they had, wanted to do. And I always, if there was a dollar to give them, they always got it.
Leo's oldest son, Gerard, was 12 when these pictures were shot, hammering away at the new hennery. Even then, he was helping his dad build, and he helped build the dairy farm big time. Gerard took over from his dad in the late 70s.
Oh yeah, we got him. Yeah.
These days, Gerard's more a businessman than farmer. While Danny looks after things in the barn, Gerard looks after the office and the investment that started with one dozen cows and a farmer with a vision.
I thank God every day that Dad had the determination and the will to start off the dairy farm, because it's a big risk, I don't know if we could have been able to do it. That was something that he was able to do, and he passed it on to us, and then we built the farm to where it is today.
Danny and his older brother Calvin went away for a while. Danny worked in a mine in Ontario for 2 years. Calvin had a short stint in a paper mill. It taught them the farm was what they wanted. They've been home ever since. And Gerard, well, he never left in the first place.
It never ever crossed my mind that I would want to leave to go anywhere to work, because the animals, the dairy, that was my passion, and I just wanted to grow the farm. And I took over from my father the dairy operation, and it was a big responsibility on my shoulders. And but I just felt that I had to do it, and because we were a large family, and most of the family depended on me to make the right decisions.
One of Gerard's decisions brought the Cormier cows here, to New World Dairy in St. David's, about a 45-minute drive from the valley. In 2004, the Cormiers inquired about a merger with New World Dairy, and when that merge happened, it made this operation one of the biggest in the entire country. Forces combined, they milk 1,000 cows a day in this parlor with a state-of-the-art rotating milking system. Close to 25% of all the milk produced in this province comes from this farm. The cows are milked 3 times every 24 hours. It's a massive production, a continuous cycle of milking, feeding, and hoof trimming. It's a cycle this man is intimately familiar with. Wilson Chaffee, the woods worker who turned dairy farmer in the late 60s, just a few years after Leo got into milking cows in the valley. Wilson's son runs New World Dairy now, but it's the farm Wilson and his wife Marie started, with just four cows.
Four cows, yeah. Of course, we really, when we started, we just more or less thought we'd just milk a few cows and sell a bit of butter and cream and carry on with the wood's work. But as we got into it a little deeper, we discovered that we couldn't do both. So we decided that we'd stay with the milk. And of course, I think it proved it okay.
Wilson's supposedly retired now, but still spends his days underneath a cow, kind of. He and his daughter-in-law trim hooves twice a week. They'll go through 40 to 50 cows a day. It's tedious work, but not nearly as bad as those early years in the 60s when Wilson and his wife were just getting started.
It was just terrible then. There was an awful lot of hard work to it and a lot of long, long hours. It was 7 days a week and countless hours every day. So it both me and Marie, first when we started, like we trucked the milk, first to the Trans-Canada where Leo Cormier picked it up and carried it the rest of the ways. Marie did that while I was in the woods working. And so it wasn't easy, you know.
We had to haul our milk in by truck and can, 8 gallon cans. And when Wilson started, they only have a few cans. And I used to stop in at the, they used to bring it out to the high road there, and I used to take their milk in too. And I didn't want to charge them and anything. And well, Wilson said, "You got to take something." Oh, I said, "Give me 10 cents a can."
Little did either of those dairy pioneers know then. Their farms, run by their sons, would one day merge and become one of the largest in all of Canada.
I can't believe it. Just can't believe it. It's wonderful. I never ever dreamt that I'd see what I'm seeing today.
More than a tractor trailer load of milk a day. 1,000 cows milked a day. And it all grew from Leo Cormier's even dozen and Wilson Chaffee's four. Is it any wonder Wilson ended up in the Atlantic Agricultural Hall of Fame, as did Leo. He was inducted in 1998.
I cried. I couldn't keep the tears from coming in my eyes. I thought that was something else.